here in the tri-state.
It is President's Day tomorrow. A lot of kids off school, but unfortunately heading outside to play in the yard or the park probably won't be ideal.
Not the best idea. With more rain on the way, especially down toward the Ohio River, as Brad was talking about, the prep's ongoing as the river continues to rise. We enjoyed the sunshine today. This is what it looked like earlier this afternoon down on the Ohio River. The water continuing to rise at or above flood stage working through the afternoon. And then also you're sending us your pictures and videos of what you're seeing in your backyard as well. Nancy sent us these photos out of their bedroom window over in New Richmond, Claremont County, and Haley sent us this photo from Georgetown of some flooding going on there. Send us your pictures and videos of what you're seeing. Go to burst.com/local12. We would love to see what you are seeing. The Ohio River, it's on the way up right now, 52.48 feet and rising, well above flood stage by the time we get to the middle of the week. That's the crest Tuesday night into Wednesday morning, just shy of 56 feet. 56 feet is defined as a moderate flood, so we are flirting with that line. And keep in mind, with more rain on the way, adjustments could be made to that as we go through the next 2 to 3 days. Right now, 42 at the International Airport under a mostly cloudy sky, feeling like the 30s with a breezy southeast wind at about 10 miles an hour. We'll keep the clouds in with temperatures rising as we head into the overnight hours tonight. Upper 40s by the time we hit 5 o'clock in the morning, 50s as you're on the way out the door with rain showers as we head into tomorrow morning. Expect those rain showers to continue into the early afternoon hours, and that's just one of multiple rounds of rain on the way. Clouds moving in from the west. We've got high pressure well off to the east that gave us our sunshine today. With that off to the east, we're going to get a good southerly flow right into the tri-state. That's going to bring more moisture and those chances of rain before our frontal boundary back here over portions of Iowa, Nebraska, working into Kansas as well, moves into the tri-state as we head toward the middle of the week. So overnight tonight, clouds hanging with us, rain on the board by the time we get towards 6-7 o'clock tomorrow morning with temperatures into the 50s. Some of this could be on the moderate side, so give yourself some extra time to get to school. Well, schools that are in tomorrow and work tomorrow morning, but we'll keep the clouds in tomorrow afternoon into tomorrow evening and into Tuesday as well. And then we knock up the temperatures into the 70s as we get toward Tuesday, mid to upper 60s by Tuesday morning, 70s by the afternoon. Maybe a few showers on Tuesday, but the clouds still hanging around as that frontal boundary moves in. As we go from Tuesday night into Wednesday, that is our next chance of rain. And even with some of the yellow on here, I wouldn't rule out an isolated thunderstorm as we go into Wednesday as well, with another round of moderate to heavy rain across the tri-state. That frontal boundary stalls off to the east as we go from Wednesday night and into Thursday. So we will keep the rain in the forecast early Thursday, and then it comes back with a vengeance as we go into Friday, late morning into the afternoon and beyond the end of the week. Rain still in the forecast Friday night into Saturday, as well as into this time next week. So almost 7 days of rain before it's all said and done. With that high pressure center anchored well off to the east over portions of Virginia and the Carolinas, we're going to get that good southerly flow right into the tri-state. Lots of moisture coming from the Gulf of Mexico. So that red on here, that is 2.5 to 4 inches of rain over the next 7 days. So any flooding concerns we've got on the Ohio River and even some backwater problems going on the Licking River down in Campbell County, as well as the Little Miami River, are only going to stay with us or possibly even get worse as we head through the week with this much rain on the way. Temperatures rising into the 50s by early tomorrow morning, mid to upper 60s by the afternoon, rain showers in the morning, breezy winds the entire day. Then we're talking record temperatures by the time we get to Tuesday. 77 for a forecast high. Keep in mind, we should be into the middle 40s for this time in February. The record high for Tuesday, 72 back in 2016. So not long ago. We're not going to break the record. We are going to shatter it as we head into Tuesday. 60s with that frontal boundary on Wednesday as it pulls through with more rain in the forecast heading through the end of the week and the weekend. Temperatures into the 50s and 60s. Keep an eye on those creeks and streams as we go throughout the week as well. We will more than likely see a flood watch over the next couple days for what rain we are going to be looking at, and we'll keep you updated on the Ohio River as well. Dwayne and Megan.
All right, thanks.